Welcome back to the Smart Tips channel. Today we're going to make a soldering iron using an old spark plug. Step 1. Electrical connector and spark plug guy took out an old spark plug that I had kept from the last time I replaced the one on my motorbike. It was still quite sturdy, but no longer usable for the engine. I thought, why not turn it into part of a DIY tool? I found a small copper electrical connector, usually used for joining wires. I carefully inserted the spark plug into it and tightened the screw. It felt like I had just created a new connection. The beginning of this project. Step 2. AA battery and casing next. I grabbed an AA battery. I knew that dismantling a battery could be dangerous because of the chemicals inside. Using a utility knife, I gently peeled off the metal casing. Step 3. Removing the battery head and cleaning the core. I used pliers to take off the battery's head, then slowly pulled out the core. This was the part I wanted to reuse. I placed it on the table and sprayed a little WD-40 to clean it, removing dirt and preventing rust. I wiped it dry with tissue, and the core looked brighter and cleaner. I told the viewers, here's a little tip: WD-40 isn't just for mechanics. It can also clean small metal parts like this. Step 4. Sharpening the core. I mounted the battery core onto my handheld drill. As the drill spun, I pressed sandpaper against it to sharpen the tip. The sound screeched and tiny sparks appeared. I filmed this in slow motion so viewers could see how a rough battery core was transformed into a sharp, shiny point. I thought to myself, it's like I'm forging a new metal tip. Step 5. Attaching to the spark plug and heating after sharpening. I removed the core from the drill and fitted it into the electrical connector attached to the spark plug. I used a lighter to heat the tip, allowing the metal to expand and lock more firmly. I reminded viewers, this is just a demonstration, don't overheat it, or it may deform. Step 6. Electrical wire and copper core. I took a piece of electrical wire and stripped off the plastic insulation, exposing the shiny copper strands inside. I twisted them together and connected them to the electrical connector on the spark plug. It felt like I was gradually completing a small circuit. Step 7. Plastic tube. As the body, I found a piece of plastic tubing, the kind used for water pipes. I threaded the wire through it and secured the spark plug at one end. Overall, it looked like a small handheld device. I filmed this step from above so viewers could clearly see the structure. Step 8. Alligator, clipped at the other end of the wire. I attached an alligator clip, the type often used in electrical experiments. I secured it tightly, then tested it by clipping onto a piece of metal to check its grip. Step 9. Extra wire I took. Another piece of wire and connected both ends to two alligator clips. I explained to viewers, this will be the intermediate wire, helping us connect to the power source. Step 10. Power source, test finally. I grabbed my drill battery, a removable lithium pack, and a small car battery. I connected the alligator clips to the terminals. Carefully checking the circuits, I switched it on. A tiny spark flashed at the tip of the spark plug. I shouted, "It worked!" Throughout the process, I shared my feelings while filming. I talked about the nervousness of dismantling the battery, the excitement of sharpening the core, and the joy of seeing that first spark. I also emphasized, this is just a DIY experiment, not a finished product for long-term use. If you want to try it, be extremely careful and always put safety first. The most important thing in DIY isn't creating a perfect tool, but the process of learning, creating, and enjoying the fun of discovery. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and subscribe to the channel to catch upcoming ideas. Goodbye, and see you next time.